ABCD parameters are found to be A and D as cos H gamma L, B and C as B is equal to ZC sin H gamma L, and C as 1 by ZC into sin H gamma L. So we have seen this as the ABCD parameters of a long transmission line basically. Now what is gamma? Gamma is a propagation constant. We have introduced that in the in rigorous solution in deriving the expression for the sending end voltage and the sending end current using rigorous solution. I have introduced this term, which is a propagation constant. It is the root of admittance, it is the root of product of admittance and impedance, and this is the rectangular representation of this propagation constant. If you multiply gamma with L, you can write L square under the root, so that you will get Y as the total impedance, Z as the total, Y as the total admittance, Z as the total impedance. Okay, so this is another rectangular representation of gamma L. In addition to propagation constant, we also introduced one more term in the previous class, which is characteristic impedance, and the characteristic impedance is given by root of small z by y. It is the impedance per unit length and it is the admittance per unit length. When you multiply with L on the numerator and denominator, you will get the total impedance divided with total admittance. So this is about the characteristic impedance ZC, propagation constant gamma, and the ABCD parameters for long transmission line. Okay. Now we will see how to evaluate these ABCD parameters. There are different methods that we can follow. We will see first method. So in the first method, we will apply directly the hyperbolic trigonometric rule. Okay. So applying directly hyperbolic trigonometrical expression or identity. Okay. So applying directly hyperbolic trigonometrical identity. Okay, by applying directly the hyperbolic trigonometrical identity, you can find A, B, C, D values. First of all, what is gamma L? Gamma L is just now we have seen it is given by alpha L plus j beta L in rectangular form. Hence, cos H gamma L can be written as cos H of, in place of gamma L, if I substitute alpha L plus j beta L, you will get cos H of alpha L plus j beta L. The formula for this is, it is like A, it is like B. Okay, it is like A plus JB. Cos H of A plus JB can be written as cos HA cos beta plus J into sin HA sin beta. Now let me expand this. So it is cos H alpha L. So let me erase this. So this is, so first term is cos H alpha L cos beta L plus J into sin H alpha L sin beta L. Here L is nothing but the length of the transmission line. This is cos H gamma L value. Similarly, sin H gamma L value is equal to sin H of alpha L plus J beta L, and it is equal to cos H of alpha L. Sin H of alpha L, sin H alpha L cos beta L. So sin H alpha L sin cos beta L cos beta L plus J into cos H alpha L sin beta L. So these are the two trigonometrical identities in hyperbolic function of which are used to find the cos H gamma L value and the sin H gamma L value. If you find cos H gamma L and sin H gamma L, if you observe ABCD values, it contains cos h gamma l as well as sin h gamma l. In addition to that, you have Zc. So if you find, if you know Zc value, and if you evaluate cos h gamma l and sin h gamma l by using this mathematical identity, you can easily find ABCD parameter. So, but here in the first method, we need to keep in our mind that when you are substituting alpha l and beta l in the calculator, inside cos h or cos whatever it may be, you need to substitute alpha l and beta l in radian. Okay, so as alpha l and beta l are in radian, after you find the rectangular representation, okay, rectangular form, after you find gamma l in rectangular form, you will get alpha l and beta l as in radian. So as alpha l and beta l are in radian, we need to evaluate cos h gamma l and sin h gamma l by keeping your calculator in radian mode. Keeping your calculator in radian mode. Okay. If you forget to keep your calculator in radian mode, it will lead to a wrong result. Okay. So that is the reason why we don't prefer this generally, because many times we do the numerical problems by keeping your calculator in degrees mode. If you forget to keep our calculator in radians mode and find this cos gamma l and sin gamma l value, you will lead to a wrong result of ABCD parameter. That's why we generally don't prefer this, but when it is asked specifically, in order to find ABCD parameters by exact solution, by exact method, because there is no approximations taken here, there is no approximations taken here, or there is no assumptions taken here, so you will get ABCD parameters their exact value. When it is asked in the numerical problem, use the exact method. You can go for using method 1, otherwise there is no need to go for method 1. You will also have another method, which is method 2. It is the expansion of hyperbolic function. This method is called as expansion of hyperbolic function. What are the hyperbolic functions here? You have cos h gamma l and sin h gamma l are the hyperbolic functions. So by expanding this hyperbolic function, you can find cos h gamma l and you can evaluate them. Now, what is the expansion of cos h gamma l in terms of gamma l? It is like cos h theta. Cos h theta expansion is 1 plus theta square divided by 2 factorial plus theta power 4 by 4 factorial plus and so on. This is the expansion of cos h theta. In place of theta, you have gamma l. Hence, I can write cos h gamma l as 1 plus gamma square l square, because gamma l whole square, divided by 2 factorial plus gamma power 4 l power 4 by 4 factorial plus and so on. Now, by considering only the first two terms, neglecting the higher order terms, okay, so let me write here, neglecting the higher order terms, because when you increase the order of this function, the value of that particular term will be a lesser value. So neglecting the higher order terms other than 2, neglecting the higher order terms or considering the first two terms, you will get cos h gamma l as 1 plus gamma l whole square, gamma l whole square by 2 factorial is 2. So this is the approximate value of cos h gamma l. Now, just now we have seen at the starting, gamma l value is given by root capital Y into Z, gamma l value. Now here you have gamma l whole square. If you take the square here and here, here square and root gets cancelled. So in place of gamma l square, you will have capital Y into Z, capital Y into Z. Now, how can I write cos h gamma l value? Cos h gamma l value is approximately equal to 1 plus gamma L square value is y into z by 2. Now, for long transmission line, what is A value and D value? It is cos its gamma L value. So, cos its gamma L value is this. It is nothing but A or D is almost equal to 1 plus yz by 2 by neglecting the higher order terms. Okay. Next, we'll go for sin h gamma L, expanding sin h gamma L. If you expand sin h gamma L, it comes out to be what is the expansion of sin h theta? Sin h theta expansion is theta plus theta cube by 3 factorial plus theta power 5 by 5 factorial plus and so on. This is sin h theta. So in place of theta, you have gamma L here. So now you will get gamma L plus gamma L whole cube by 3 factorial plus and so on. Or you can write gamma L power 5 by 5 factorial plus and so on. Now if you observe, here also we are neglecting the higher order terms. So neglecting higher order terms means we are considering only up to power 3 here. Neglecting higher order terms or considering only first two terms in the expansion, you will get sin h gamma L value as gamma L plus gamma L whole cube divided with 3 factorial. 3 factorial value is 6. Okay. So this is approximate value. So sin h gamma L is approximately equal to gamma L plus gamma L whole cube by 6. Now, by taking gamma L as common here, I may get inside the brackets, it has 1 plus gamma L whole square by 6. So, this is sin h gamma L value. Just now, we have seen at the starting again, what is the gamma L value? It is root yz. Gamma L square value, gamma L whole square value, yz. If you take the square on both sides, you will get that. Now, here you have gamma L, hence I can write sin h gamma L as approximately equal to gamma L as root times yz multiplied with 1 plus gamma L square value is yz, so yz by 6. This is sin h gamma L value, but what is the B value? It is not equal to sin h gamma L. It is Zc into sin h gamma L, B value. The parameter B is Zc into sin h gamma L. So, B is equal to, what is Zc? Zc is the characteristic impedance. It is the root of capital Z divided with capital Y. And it is multiplied with root yz into 1 plus yz by 6. Right? Now, here in the denominator you have root y, in the numerator you have root y, so root y gets cancelled, and in the numerator you have root z and you have another root z into root z will give you z. Now b is approximately equal to, b is approximately equal to z into 1 plus yz by 6. Okay, so this is b value. Similarly, what is the C value? C is approximately equal to, or first of all, let me write it as equal to, C is equal to sin h gamma L divided by Z. Okay? If Zc is the root of Z by Y, what is 1 by Zc? It is root of Y by Z. Hence, I can write C as root of capital Y by capital Z multiplied with sin h gamma L is root of capital Y into Z multiplied with 1 plus yz by 6. Now, here in the denominator you have root Z, in the numerator you have root Z, both will get cancelled, and here you have root Y multiplied with root Y, it will give you Y. So, C is approximately equal to Y into 1 plus yz by 6. 1 plus yz by 6. Okay. So, for your understanding, let me write all the parameters at a single place. So, A as well as d is almost equal to 1 plus yz by 2. Similarly, b is equal to b approximately equal to z into b is approximately equal to z into 1 plus yz by 6. Similarly, c is approximately equal to y into 1 plus yz by 6. So these are the ABCD parameters for a long transmission line. Means if you evaluate these values, you can automatically obtain ABCD parameter. So this approximation, because we have approximated here, is it right? So this approximation will give more accurate results. This approximation gives us a fairly accurate result, gives us fairly, not exact result, but fairly accurate result, for length of the transmission line, for length between ranging between 400 kilometers to 500 kilometers, right? So if the length of the long transmission line ranges between 400 kilometers and 500 kilometers, this approximation gives us fairly accurate result, right? As they are very simple to find, we can use this method when and only when if the length of the transmission line lies in between, if the length is in between 400 to 500 kilometers. If the length of the transmission line is between 400 to 500 kilometers, then you will get a fairly accurate result when you do this approximation of neglecting the higher order term, so that you can find ABCD values in a very easy manner when compared to first method. Okay? This is about the second method. Let us see the third method. Method 3. Okay. Now, this is related to exponentials of hyperbolic functions. Okay, so this is also an exact method. So in all the three methods, first method and the third method are exact methods, whereas the second method is an approximation method. But when the length of the transmission line is in between 400 to 500 kilometers, we will definitely go for approximation method instead of going for exact method, okay, which will increase the amount of calculations required. Okay? So that is the reason why you will go for method 2. Now let us see the third method, which is the exponentials of hyperbolic function. So we know that cos h gamma l can be written as in terms of exponential. See here, we know that cos h theta can be written as e power theta plus e power minus theta by 2. In place of theta, you have gamma l here. Hence, I can write it as e power gamma l plus e power minus gamma l by 2. What is gamma l? If you write this in rectangular form, you will get alpha l plus j beta l. Hence, I can write gamma l as e power alpha l. So, in place of gamma l, I am writing e power alpha l plus j beta l plus e power alpha minus alpha l minus j beta l, because it is minus gamma l, total divided with 2. This is cos h gamma l value. Now, how can I write this exponential? Single exponential can be written as two exponentials by multiplying their power. So I can write this term here as e power alpha l into e power j beta l. Okay, so it remains unchanged. You can write it as e power alpha l plus j beta l, or e power alpha l into e power j beta l. As the bases are same, you can add the exponential, which will give you the same term as the previous step. Now the second term can be written as e power minus alpha l into e power minus j beta l total divided with 2. This is cos h gamma l value, right? Now what is e power j theta? E power j theta can be written as at an angle theta. Simple, very simple. We can write e power j theta as cos theta plus I sin theta. Cos theta plus I sin theta is nothing but angle theta. So similarly here e power j beta l can be written as angle beta l. Hence cos h gamma l can be found by using the relation. Let me write here. Cos h gamma l can be found by using the relation. It is equal to e power alpha l at an angle of beta l. E power alpha l is a real value, beta l is angle, plus e power minus alpha l at an angle of minus beta l total divided with 2. Okay, so this is cos h gamma l value, or it is also equal to a and d. As this is an exact method, we can go for using this method without any problem. And what is sin h gamma l? Let me write sin h gamma l value. In order to know sin h gamma l value, you need to know sin h theta value. Sin h theta is e power theta minus e power minus theta by 2. This is the formula for sin h theta. Now in place of theta we have gamma l. Hence, I can write this as e power gamma l minus e power minus gamma l by 2. Now, how can I write gamma l? Gamma l can be written as alpha l plus j beta l. So, it is e power alpha l plus j beta l minus e power minus alpha l minus j beta l total divided with 2. Now, I am writing it in terms of two exponential, product of two exponential. So I can write it as e power alpha l into e power j beta l minus e power minus alpha l into e power minus j beta l whole divided with 2. Now sin h gamma l value is equal to e power alpha l at an angle of beta l minus e power minus alpha l at an angle of beta l total divided with 2. So this is the formula for sin h gamma l. Okay, so this is the formula for sin h gamma l, and this is the formula for cos h gamma l. In this way you can find sin h gamma l and cos h gamma l value, and then later you can find ABCD values easily. But you need to remember one thing here: when you find gamma l in rectangular form, you will get alpha l and beta l values by equating this gamma l to this equation and rectangular terms to this equation. You will get alpha l and beta l value, but the beta l value which you find here is in radian. But here you need to substitute beta l in degree. Okay, so the important note here is, so beta l, as beta l value is in radian, as beta l value is obtained in radian, when you convert the polar form of gamma l into rectangular form, you will get alpha l and beta l value. But beta l value is in radian, hence is obtained as beta l value is obtained in radian, we need to convert it into degrees. And then substitute here, okay, in sin h gamma l expression and in cos h gamma l expression, we need to substitute beta l values in degrees. But the beta l value which we obtain from gamma l is in radian, and but you need to convert this in degrees. Okay, so this is the only thing which you need to understand, or the only thing which you need to take care when you are finding ABCD or when you are evaluating ABCD parameter using the method called exponentials of hyperbolic function. So this is about the first method. This is about the first method applying the hyperbolic trigonometric identities directly. Second method is expansion of hyperbolic function. And the third method is exponentials of hyperbolic function. By using all these three methods, you can find ABCD parameter. But when compared to all the three methods, second method is the easiest method of evaluating ABCD parameter. But it will give fairly accurate results when the length of the transmission line is in between 400 kilometers to 500 kilometers. Otherwise, you can go for method 1 or method 2. Whereas in method 1, you need to keep a thing with, in your mind that you need to keep the calculator in radian mode when you are finding cos h gamma l and sin h gamma l value. Whereas in method 3 also, you need to keep one important note in your mind, which is beta l value, which we can obtain is in radian. So we need to convert it into degrees. Okay. So this is about all the three ways. So this is about all the three ways of evaluating ABCD parameters of long transmission line. I hope it is clear for you up to now.